Hi friends, I'm Pastor Diana.
Welcome to a daily devotion. I'm so glad you've chosen to take a moment to pause in the midst of your day to spend some time with God. Today we are continuing to explore our series Called and exploring callings in our lives. I'm so grateful to our friends at Vibrant Faith who have created this Calling Now devotion that we are using as our daily devotions. They include some wonderful videos by average everyday people who are talking about their callings. Today we hear the story of Randy, who wrestles with what happens when you can't do what you're called to do. And that's one of life's hardest things, isn't it? We have a drive, a passion, something inside us that just is calling us, something that we love to do, and then we can't. So what does a calling mean when you can't pursue it? How do we cope with the uncertainties of life that are keeping us from doing the things that we love? Well, in the first letter to the Corinthians, Paul writes a short proclamation that might help speak to us of those times when we're cut off from what we know we are called to do. Paul writes this: "Each person should stay in the situation they were in when they were called. Each person should stay in the situation they were in when they were called." So what does that mean to be called and then to not be able to do it, but to stay in the situation? Well, Randy's story makes clear that sometimes there are circumstantial roadblocks, but that doesn't always mean that it's the end of the story, because God calls us still, always, at all ages. God can help us adapt to our conditions to figure out ways that we can express our callings in different ways that fit where we are. And God can help us grieve what we've lost. Challenging circumstances do not have to get in the way of God's calling. We may still need to seek healing or justice or a resolution to a blocked calling. We may continue to need to listen for another call. And most of all, we need to be honest where we are and be in conversation with God, asking our questions. But you know, God calls us, and God will help us through whatever God is calling us to do. So thanks be to God for that. Amen. Amen.